Okay, now for something completely different that has nothing to do with voting, which is which is just sort of a general interest thing which shows why Star Trek has problems, which is that when you go very, very fast, you will die. So here is a picture of Jim and the doctor. Let's see. Okay. And so he says, warp drive, Mr. Scott. And there they go, and they're all dead. And I'll tell you about this later. Okay, so here's a sort of interesting thing that people have overlooked, which is that in space there is little bits of hydrogen at 1 per cubic centimeters. If you go very fast, they go through you and irradiate you, and you're dead. Now, first of all, why would you want to go very fast? Well, the universe is very big. And Milky Way has 100 billion stars and a diameter of 100,000 light years. And to that light year is the distance light goes in 1 year. And to give you some appreciation of that, if our fastest rockets at the moment that escape the Earth and go out are going 25,000 miles an hour, that's pretty fast. The nearest star is 4 light years away. It would take 100,000 years for that rocket to get there. Okay, that gives you an idea of how big the universe is, and the the galaxy is 100,000 light years in diameter. Well, there's one thing that might help, which is relativity, and that is this factor of gamma. So what happens is you may know that moving clocks go slowly. So if you go very fast, you have this factor 1 minus v squared over c squared. So v, you get closer and closer to the speed of light, you get this factor gamma, and gamma gets very big. So you have a v over c 0.99, gamma is 7, and so on. And you get to where gamma is 100,000, so on. Well, that's the factor by which your clock slows down. So that's good, because now if you're going and you're going very, very fast, even if you're going almost at the speed of light, remember it's going to take you 50,000 years to go halfway through the galaxy. So if you want to live, well, you need to have a pretty big gamma factor, okay? So that's what I was just saying. If you want to go halfway across the galaxy, then you need to have a big gamma. So let's say you try to have a gamma so that you have something like 5,000. All right, so you have to go very, very fast. Now, first of all, I have to tell you, I'm not going to talk about this, but if you do that, to get up to that speed, you have to have a fuel load that, eventually your rocket, whatever its weight is, that like billions, trillions of times the size of the weight of your rocket. And that includes if you're totally efficiently turning matter into energy by equals mc squared. So that's a reason that it's never going to work right there. So, here's this ratio. If you have a 100-ton spaceship, you need, 4 trillion tons or whatever it is of fuel that you're turning into energy, and nobody even knows how to do that. Well, maybe you can use a light sail. People talk about that. Well, it turns out that's the problem. You can't use rockets. Okay, so here's the thing that Ed Purcell of Harvard discovered. There is this hydrogen in space, and it's a very little bit of hydrogen. It's only 1 per cubic centimeter. And if you think of normal in this room, how many atoms or molecules do we have? We have like 10 to the 20th. That's one with 20 zeros after it per cubic centimeter. So it's very little. So that might be okay, but it isn't. So the problem is, if you're going on a spaceship and you have this factor gamma, you're compressing space by a factor of gamma, right? So the problem there is, first of all, that you are going through, you're going, at least from your personal point of view, you're going through a lot of, the atoms are compressed. You're going through more of them than 1 per cubic centimeter. If you have a gamma of 1,000, now you've got 1,000 per cubic centimeter. And originally, the reason I thought of this was my son asked me when he's about 10 years old, which is 20 years ago, whether if there was any friction in space. So I said, well, there's this hydrogen. And so I calculated what happened when your ship went through space and the hydrogen bounced off, and how much friction, how much retarding force that was. And then I realized when you go fast enough, I said, wait a minute, it's not going to bounce. It's going to go right through the ship, and it's going to irradiate you. Well, if you look at these energies here, it turns out, and I'll just have to tell you that, that if you look at the proton kinetic energy, this is like, you know, the Hadron Collider in Europe? So, okay, this is like standing in front of the Hadron Collider. So that's the problem. You go really fast, okay? What's the radiation dose you get? Well, here we have in the last column there, sieverts per second. And by the way, 6 sieverts is fatal, okay? So you're getting like 60, 80, 800, 8,000 sieverts per second. So this is not going to be good for you. And furthermore, it turns out that electronics don't even survive. You know, electronics, if you have a certain amount of radiation, they get zapped. So that doesn't work.
So
what about
Bill? What you're really telling us is there's no such thing as an interstellar paper trail.
That's right. That's a good translation so everybody can understand. Joe's pointing out there's no such thing as interstellar paper trail.
Well, the guy from Priceline is a stunt double?
The guy from Priceline? Yeah. Anyway, so can you shield it? Well, the answer is no, okay, but never mind. Okay, so the hydrogen atoms are like space mines. And in fact, I was thinking of saying this, but some fundamentalists might pick it up. They were like God's little space mines. Okay, so Enrico Fermi famously asked, where are they? Meaning the aliens, if they were there. Well, they're not here because it's too far to go. It would take too much fuel for a rocket. If you went fast enough, you'd be killed by hydrogen radiation. Light sails won't save you. You can't even send instruments. Well, maybe there's wormholes or other things, but at least as far as the physics we know, you can't do it, okay? So ET, too bad. What if you're as big as a hydrogen molecule? Yeah, well, that would be okay. So anyway, this was picked up by, I gave this talk actually in this building at the APS meeting in February, and it was picked up by New Scientist, and we got 500 comments from angry Star Trek devotees who said things like, don't you know they have radiation shields or they're in a warp bubble? But my favorite, they were in a warp bubble. So my favorite comment was somebody in my favorite saying, there is no warp bubble, amigo. The doctor was talking to physicists, not Star Trek lovers in pajamas. Thanks.
All right, thank you.
Bill, I have just a comment.
Sure.
I encourage further research on this topic for voting because my sources tell me Congress is considering an amendment to UOCAVA, acronym is for Speed of Light Travelers, acronym SOL, requiring election officials to conduct pilots to determine how to get ballots back before the election deadline for travelers traveling at the speed of light. So.
Very good. Okay, yes, that's a very good point. Okay, thank you.
Next year's EVT will have an interstellar election track.